You've been away much too long.
Where was I?
Oh, I don't know. You tell me.
Oh, you mean from Dallas?
Yes.
Yes, it's been a long time. Oh, I've been here on a couple of occasions. I had a couple of meetings here, but I haven't performed here since 1952. 53.
That long?
Yeah. Well, you said it was long.
Oh, well, you were here on some movie promos. I guess that's
yeah.
That's why I was talking with you. Listen, you and I share a very dear mutual friend.
You were telling me, but you didn't tell me who.
David Hartman.
I'm out of focus, out of joy.
David Hartman. I thought that would grab you.
That's my kid brother.
I know.
That's
I know.
One of the most. Well, you can't. David Hartman.
Now, they're not really related friends, but they are like brothers.
He's my kid brother, a little yeah. dummy. Yeah.
That little dummy, 6'4" dummy.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's why I never say that in his presence. Oh, he's one of the best people that ever lived. He's the Messiah.
Do you know that he is always telling me every time I talk with him or I see him, I'm always saying, okay, David, what's the latest one-upsmanship with Jerry Lewis? And he tells me a story. Now it's your turn to tell a story.
Did he tell you about coming to Sweden?
No. I haven't talked with him that recently.
Well, I was in the middle of one of the roughest shooting days, and I was staging a scene where I was using 200-some prisoners in the concentration camp.
Now, this is your newest movie.
Yes.
Yeah, The Day the Clown Cried. Yeah,
right.
I do know about the film.
And I was really having a difficult time getting it the way I wanted it. And I was dealing with Swedish actors who did not speak English. And I had to work with a translator. And I kept spotting that I couldn't possibly get the right staging on the upper levels of the bunks, and I kept looking up there. And in the prisoner uniform, there was a face that looked familiar, but I was sure that it wasn't one of my Swedish actors. And I must have looked four times when I realized, that's David. And this dummy left Los Angeles, flew to Stockholm, got to the wardrobe department, got into a prisoner's outfit, and sat up there during the preparation of shooting the scene.
That's beautiful.
He
That's
had
David.
The greatest fun in his life because he really had me. I was in shock. I just couldn't believe it. He does that to me all the time.
I know. You're always surprising one another. And you know that I interviewed him last summer out in Los Angeles. And I asked him, as you know, David is quite a good photographer. And I said, David, please bring some of your photographs and we can show them, you know, in the interview. So the one that he had that I liked the best, he said, I won't tell you who or what that is until we get on the air. It was just a picture of your hand over Patty's hand, and it was just close-ups of hands that it was taken in the airplane on y'all's wedding anniversary, wasn't it?
Yeah, we were flying back from San Diego. We had our wedding anniversary on the boat, and I didn't even know he was shooting pictures. Patty and I were talking, and I was holding her hand. It's really a lovely, lovely shot.
It really is, and the light and everything. It's a black and white photo.
Yeah, he got lucky.
He got lucky on a couple of others.
My thumb was soft. The hand was okay. I tease him something awful. Well, he was doing a very tough scene. He was doing the John Stalin story, who was one of your Texans, as you
yes,
one of the
yes.
great, great cancer research doctors. And he was really involved heavily in this operating scene at Universal. And I had left the cutting room, and I drove over and scrubbed up, got into the whole outfit. And they were shooting the scene, and I was standing about two people away from him. And when he asked for the suture, I handed him a sticky lollipop. And they were rolling, of course, and he knew who that had to be because the hat was over the hair and the mask was there. And he got so hysterical, it took him another 20 minutes to get into the scene. So we do it to one another all the time.
You are so interested in film making and all the camera. All the film directors, excluding yourself now, Jerry. Past or present. Who are the ones you really admire the most and you just always
Artie Penn, Norm Jewison, Stu Rosenberg.
For the subject matter, I have to include Sam Peckinpah. It's a great pleasure out of seeing the esophagus laying on a child's lip. The violence is devastating, but he's a magnificent because they're the filmmakers. They know every aspect of the movie. As I believe you have to. And know literally from loading the camera to whatever.
effect that means and how you apply your actors and your effects and your pre-production to that.
Now, people you've mentioned, Norman,
which
of his films did you think was his best work?
Russian is coming.
Okay. Mr. Penn.
Super.
Mr. Penn.
Well, Bonnie and Clyde, I think.
Although again, the subject matter distresses me because of
the workmanship, the craft,
was, I think, one of the finest.
I think one of the finest things.
And the third person you mentioned was.
Well, Stu Rosenberg.
Well, Stu Rosenberg was his name.
Cool Hand Luke. Paul Newman.
Luke with Paul Newman.
And I have to include Paul in terms of directorial
know-how.
Directorial.
These are all very, very competent people. You know they're
and it's a joy to watch them. They're inspiring.
Are there any
you admire?
Oh, sure. Antonioni.
Started
as a still man.
He started as a still man, and he was a technician behind the scenes.
Full well what to do. And he was he's brilliant, brilliant filmmaker. And of course, Bergman, who I know and respect tremendously, is not a bad film.
I think most people would agree with that. Thank you, Jerry.
Thank you, Bobby.
Thank you, Bobby.
Yeah.